Hey there, YouTube. So I know it's been a little while since my last update, but I've been busy interviewing different brokers, trying to find out which brokerage would be best for me throughout this whole process. So I've passed the state exam. I've been sending emails to different brokers. I've had interviews with a few different brokers about what types of services they offer, commission splits, things like that. So with that said, I would say this is one of the harder things that I've come across since I've been going through this whole process of, going through the schooling, going through the testing, passing the state exam. Picking a broker is really tough in my opinion. Why? Because there's a lot of things that I personally am looking for in a broker that they can offer me in order for me to be able to make a successful transition into real estate. As I mentioned in my previous videos, it's very important to me to be able to work with a broker that is going to allow me to start out part-time. My goal is to eventually have real estate be my full-time career, and that's where I would be moving into from that point forward. But I need to be able to start part-time and get the training and get a few sales under my belt before I make that transition. So one thing I'm going to tell you is a lot of brokers don't want to hear that you're going to start part-time. A lot of them out there say, well, you have to do it full-time. There's no way to really get your business going if you're too busy working a full-time job. And honestly, I've spoken with a few different real estate agents and, you get mixed reviews when it comes to that. And a lot of people will try to push you to go straight to full-time. But I can tell you, there are a lot of things that you're going to have to pay for, such as the National Association of Realtors, MLS access, fees to your broker, startup costs. There's a lot of things that you'll be paying when you get into real estate that you can't just do it without having some training and something to get you going before you give up your stable paycheck. So I've made the decision after interviewing several different brokers and different programs to go with Coldwell Banker. They offered me training at the particular office that I interviewed with. It's one of the few that they offered training after 6 o'clock. So I work a normal 8 to 5 job. So being able to go to training after 6 o'clock during the week or even on the weekends, they had Saturdays that they offered training, which was at no cost to me. So that's a huge benefit to me. It's also a large office. Yeah, the commission split is, not 100%, you're not getting 100%, but you don't have to pay monthly fees where I selected. You don't have a lot of the other things that you might have to pay for, like training and things of that nature. So I really think I made the right decision. I will be starting on Monday with Coldwell Banker in Winter Park. So if any of you are local and looking for a real estate agent, I'll be happy to help you. I'm really thrilled to say that, I finally found someone that's going to work for me. Now, with that said, I can tell you that, you have to be prepared. If you're going to go and start full time, then fine. You shouldn't have a problem finding a broker that maybe has, a higher split, things like that. But for me, it was really important to find that balance of being able to transition into real estate full time. So, one other thing I wanted to mention too is that when it comes to the potential brokers that you're interviewing, keep in mind that it's not necessarily, all Keller Williams are created equal, or all Coldwell Bankers, or all Century 21s, or whatever the brokerage firm may be. I chose a larger firm because of the training and the materials and all the resources that they have to be able to help a new agent get their business started properly. I'm hoping it's the right choice. Obviously, this is the first time I'm going through it, so I'm no expert by any means. But I've talked to a lot of people, I've talked to a lot of brokerages, I've had a lot of conversations, so I feel I've made the right choice for me. With that said, the other thing that I can tell you is important when you first start out is you have to know how to be able to start your business. If you've never done real estate before, there's so much to know. So training, to me, is more important than a commission split when you first get started. And you can always negotiate that down the road after you make your first sales and you start getting your business off the ground. So Yeah, I'm a little nervous. It's something that I've never done before, but I've made it this far, so I really think, if I continue to put in the amount of effort that I have so far, it'll really pay off. So, if you have any questions, leave it in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more content. Thanks, and have a great day.